आज एक कार्यक्रम को हम शुरुआत करने जा रहे हैं। मित्रों, 2019 नवंबर में जब भारत में सर्दियों की शुरुआत हुई और मखमली सर्दियों का आनंद हम ले रहे थे, तभी चीन के मध्य प्रांत वुहान से एक ऐसा वायरस सबके बीच आ खड़ा हुआ जिसने ना सिर्फ एक उस शहर को बल्कि पूरी दुनिया को एक ऐसे चौराहे पर खड़ा कर दिया जहां सिर्फ काल और काल और काल ही दिखाई देता है। ये एक ऐसा दौर है कि जिस दौर में इस वायरस ने पूरे विश्व के अंदर अपना विकराल रूप दिखाया और लगभग 200 देश आज इस काल में समा गए। 200 देश की सरकारें एक सामान्य व्यक्ति से लेके हर एक आम आदमी आज इसके डर के साये में जी रहा है और उसकी परिणति ऐसी रही कि आज हम सभी लोग अपने घरों में आकर बैठ गए। एक ऐसा दृश्य सामने आया जिसकी कल्पना शायद युग युगांतर न तो पहले कभी किसी ने की होगी, न हम आने वाली पीढ़ियों को यह दिखाना चाहते। लेकिन हर रात के बाद एक अंधेरा होता है, अंधेरे के बाद उजाला होता है और उजाले की किरण के साथ आज डॉक्टर सुधीर भारद्वाज, डायरेक्टर ऑफ डिवाइन इंटरनेशनल ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन, वेलकम यू ऑल इन द इंटरनेशनल वेब सेमिनार ऑन द अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड चैलेंजेस ऑफ फार्मासिस्ट फॉर इन दैट एकेडमिक सिचुएशन ऑफ कोरोना और COVID-19। फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सो हैप्पी टू अनाउंस यू that you all has given me a lot of love. All are coming together with us. On that time, I would like to welcome and just want to blessing from the Dr. Sraf sir. Sir is available. Sir, pranam kar raha hu charan sparsh sir.
All the very best. You are doing a good job.
Sir, so from the side of Association of Registered Pharmacists from the Divine International, we all are welcoming you. I would also like to welcome Dr. Vikas Sharma, President of Association of Registered Pharmacists. I would like to welcome Mr. Rajesh Singh Jadon, a Secretary of ARP, Dr. Vivek Singh Bhadoria, CEO of Divine International Pharmacy, Mr. Pratap Singh Jadon, Advisor of ARP, and the number of person from all over the world that really give it to me a lot of love, support, trust. I just want to welcome on behalf of all my team. Thank you very much for coming on that session, for joining us on that international seminar. Thank you so much, everyone. We have started ARP with a very simple aim, that we would make a one platform where all the pharmacists, they would come together, make some new platform to give something to new generation as well as collect some information from the elders. So we can play a very good or important role in the society. That is a more main motto of that ARP, and we are planning for that. I'll not take more time. I'll say a few words of sloka. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma, Tashmay Sri Gurve Nama. My guru, my mentor, and a person, they have given me always a positive positivity and positive attitude to me, and made me, not only me, number of students, they are just working with the flame of Dr. Sraf. They are taking energy from Dr. Sraf, and I'll not take a more time to, I just do not want to come in between you and Dr. Sraf. Sir is a legendary person, and that's not a word for the legendary. Sir is legendary because sir has really made a number of legends. Sir has given a wave to positive energy to thousands of students. They are working in the society, they are working in the healthcare sector. And that epidemic situation, number of students of sir is already working. So I'll not take a more time. I'll just come to sir. Sir, please give your views, and in that inaugural session, please bless us all. Thank you very much, sir. Please, sir.
Thank you very much, Sudhir, for your nice words and feeling. My energy comes from all my good students, young leaders. And I'm really happy you have mentioned I'm trying to become a leader, but the foremost requirement to become a leader, you should know the art of grooming the leadership. So I'm trying my best to groom the leadership. And up to some extent, I am successful also, because pan-India, there are leaders who are connected and they are doing their good job, whatever assigned to them. So officially, I should thank Association of Registered Pharmacists for this initiative, particularly Divine Institute, to organize such type of activity in tough times. This is the responsibility of all of us. And I want to place on record the appreciation to the president of association, Vikas Sudhir. And I'm calling all of you by first name. This I got this right being a teacher, Pratap, Rajesh, and other leaders from that region. You are really, you deserve compliment. You are organizing such type of activity and providing an opportunity even in the lockdown period for the learning and capacity building one and all. So my greetings, welcome all the participants, and I brought you greetings from Pharmacy Council of India, and I am also greeting on my own behalf, and I am wishing you a very successful seminar on today and tomorrow. Before starting my statement, as all of you know that I am holding position of a professor in a university and a portfolio in the Pharmacy Council of India also. So I put my disclaimer that whatever I am saying, this is my personal views, and whatever data I am using, this is also available in public domain. So there is no conflict. But as Sudhir unusually started with a negative note, we are under trouble. This is the event which has gave us opportunity to tell your generations what you have experienced in lifetime. This is not tailor-made. This is given by the God. Although I am also under some fear, but at the same time, this is the opportunity to introspect yourself, come out with your new ideas, because whenever there are challenges, there are opportunities. So we cannot choose one side of coin. You have to accept both sides of the coin at a time. So we have accepted the challenges, and we have converted these challenges into opportunities. As far as 2020 is concerned, this is a very, very important year for different reasons. And one of the reasons for Pharmacy Academy also, because I also considered this 2020 as a digital divide. The last few days I am talking about this AC and VC, before crisis and after crisis. So C means leader, coupled with AICT as far as these regulations concerned, dual regulation, we are victim. We were suffering. There was a crisis and there was a conflict. So in March 2020, this problem is also resolved. So now we are in an era that is after crisis, after coupled mechanism, and after the conflict with other organizations. So I would like to congratulate all of you for this also. Now your profession will be maintained, regulated by you people only. Whosoever there in council, we all are temporary there, but council will remain because it is still there. And for your information, the beautiful judgment given by AICT, they have clearly mentioned this is the oldest act and prevailing. This is the specialized act also. And they have categorically mentioned council, the Pharmacy Council of India, can regulate the profession through its own acts, ordinances, and regulations. So I would like to place on record the appreciation and support of one and all to achieve this landmark in our pharmacy profession, that too in our lifetime. Even if talk about this pandemic, this is a journey everybody knows. Outwork worst was there in the month of December, in March, in China. Then it was declared as this local problem, but finally it was declared as a pandemic. And this pandemic was characterized by a new entry of a new virus, a big family of MERS and SARS family. And this International Committee on Taxonomy on Viruses given the name COVID-19. And since then we are seeing, but we being a human being, we are sure that we will success over this particular problem, and it must be just a temporary problem, nothing more than that. What I'm saying is, when you are staying inside, so we are really exploring a lot of potential from ourselves only. Because if you're talking about this online teaching, blended learning and all that, so there was inertia, there was resistance from different corners. Overnight, once this pandemic is declared, everybody is staying at home and they have adopted like anything. Everybody was familiar with the smartphones, technology, only thing they were not using. So now they are using the technology, they start learning, and the teachers also, they have adopted and they start teaching students through online mode and different modes. So this is another opportunity. When you are unable to move outside, so this is sufficient scope to move inside. And I can say in last more than 5 decades, this is the first opportunity I got to see inside. So this is in 15, 20 days are still left. So visit your inner sight and find out how unique you are. And once you come out with your idea of what is the unique feature of yourself, your journey must be very easy, and you will achieve the laurels to this particular profession and country. As far as this pandemic is concerned and role of pharmacists is concerned, so a few days back we were talking, discussing in different platforms, there is a lot of pharmacists available and this and that, unemployment. At that time also I was mentioned a number of times, they are never a liability, they are assets. But at that time, we cannot foresee this pandemic will happen. But now, after this particular rebalancing of the business and economy worldwide, everybody is looking at India. And one of the most important, highlight of this country is we have sufficient technically trained manpower. And I think when we are visualizing to become world leader and world guru, at the same time leader in the industrial scenario also. So all the countries are now relocating to different places, and India is a preferred destination. Earlier it was identified only for pharmaceuticals and biotechnology as a preferred destination. Now we can understand most of the industries are now aiming to come to India to start their economy. During this tough time, this is our moral responsibility to place on record the appreciation those pharmacists who are working in the forefront. At the same time, all of us can salute all the medical professionals, those who are working, they are fighting at the forefront. As far as the neo-patriotism is concerned, this definition gives an idea that only patriotism is not required during the wars. This is even during the peace and sometime during internal emergency also. So this people we are realizing, this is internal emergency, and all the warriors were fighting. So this time we have seen a different, experience, because our forces are recognizing the contribution of health warriors, and as a mark of appreciation, they are flying from west to east this morning, this day, just to place on record the contribution of health warriors. At the same time, a few naval helicopters are going to shower the flowers on different hospitals, again to boost the morals. I was given to understand that there are specialized teachers, specialized source persons who are going to talk about the specific issues on COVID-19. So I, this is just, as you said, this inaugural remark. So I would like to highlight the contribution made by the pharmacists in particular. For years together, we were talking about the recognition in the society. At that time, I always mentioned, respect is always commanded, not demanded. This opportunity came when we were in position to command the respect, and I salute one and all that now we are in position, we are commanding the respect. You should realize, when Government of India, we have advocacy with the Government of India, they call for the numbers of the pharmacist. We have given the number, this is 11,099,000, 11,99,000. At the same time, this is the old data. Whenever we are going to refresh and recollect the data from different state pharmacy council, this data must go beyond 15 lakhs. So you can understand, you can have a sense of pride that you are a member of a club where the number of the members is more than 15 lakhs, so 15 lakhs pharmacist. At the same time, one more important asset we have, at least 500 young pharmacists, budding pharmacists are there in the institutions. You can just imagine what workforce we have. Only thing, as a teacher, we have to bring them into mainstream and we have to educate. If you talk about the industrial pharmacist, this is the only industry which is going on. And at the same time, if you talk about two drugs only, you can say hydroxychloroquine and paracetamol, besides the domestic needs, 70% supply of the world is from India only. So again, we have to place on record and we have to appreciate the industrial pharmacists, those who are working in pharmaceutical fields, that they are doing a wonderful job. And further, they are working on certain ideas also. So I am sure that they must come up with some good results and they will bring the respect and laurels to this country. Those who are working with nurses and doctors on the front line, we only can boost their morals because they have to, and request them, because if you want to make sure that society is safe, you have to make sure you are also safe. Please take precautions. This is the only thing we can have, and we can boost the morals. We have no doubt we will celebrate, we will felicitate all of you once this this crisis is over, but you are really doing a wonderful job. At the same time, the pharmacists working in community pharmacy, they are the most we can say soft targets, because the persons going to visit them, they are not identified. They are unknown people. And there are certain cases where they are silent carriers also. So please take ultimate care. Devise your own mechanism as far as the social distancing is concerned. You are bound to serve. Please keep on serving the society, because somehow we are recognized by the society for our noble work. But take care. Take the precautions. There are guidelines from WHO, FIP, Government of India. You please follow those guidelines. Besides that, over and above, you can take further devices and mechanism to for your personal safeguard. One more observation I have, there is overload of informations. And this overload of information, there's contradictions also. So I'm urging upon all of you to please follow the guidelines of the Government of India only. This is time when we need not to advise anything, because there is a central mechanism, and if we are creating anything, we are giving anything, it may create problem for the masses. So we have to follow the, at the same time, we have to educate the people, need not to worry, because there are certain cases reported as far as psychological intervention is required for those cases. So this is again our responsibility. You have to educate the society. If you are staying safe, if you are staying alone, if you are staying maintaining the social distance, need not to worry. Even if you have some exposure, there are chances, there are fair chances that you must be all right within a very small period of time. Only problem we have to suggest to the elderly people and those who are already challenged medically for different other reasons. So they, again, they have to take precaution. As far as advice concerned to the academic institutions, so Pharmacy Council of India was the first statutory body which come out with the advisory to all the academic institutions and colleges and teachers and students to adopt different mechanism models and giving a lot of freedom as far as the relaxation in regulation is concerned for one-time basis, looking into this pandemic. But still, there is, if any hardship, though this pharmacy council office is not working physically, but we all are working from our homes, and we are also adopted the online mechanism and platforms. So even we are not going to office, office is not opening, but all the activities are going on as usual. So if there is any hardship, please let us know. We'll come out and we'll discuss and we'll try to resolve this problem. As far as contribution of teachers concerned, friends, I compliment you, I congratulate you, I felicitate you for your efforts for transforming yourself from a classroom teacher to world-class mentors. And this is required. It was the need of the hour. We were lingering on this particular transformation. But thanks to this pandemic that we have adopted overnight, and you become world-class mentor. What is expected? I always mentioned the beauty of this time. Students are more knowledgeable, more informed than the previous years. So only thing, we have to better utilize the talent. And for that, you are supposed to be on toes. And you have to put all your informations on website. And when I'm talking about putting all the informations on website and all that, so it means you are in the glass house. And when you are in the glass house, because whatever the notes you are putting, whatever PowerPoint presentations you are putting, it is subject to plagiarism check. So there must be some personal contribution. And if there is anything you are mentioning there, you have to acknowledge, you have to properly take permission. So this also you have to learn. As far as Pharmacy Council of India is concerned, we are also sincerely thinking and turning on this issue, and we are also planning to have our own online platform for the teaching and learning, and to provide the authentic material to all the stakeholders of this country. And very soon it must be reality with the contribution of all the teachers of this country. As far as student is concerned, dear student friends, we are living a different era. This is a time of Industry 4.0, where simple learning and relearning is not required. You are supposed to learn, unlearn, and relearn. One of the sociologists, he was mentioning that the problem with the institution is that we have to prepare graduates who can solve the problem of the society, which is not known to the society. And that too, they are supposed to solve those problems with the help of tools not yet invented. It means we have to teach the students the art of learning, not the material. Our informations. We have to make them leaders. We have to make them a professional, so that they have this skill to adopt the to face the challenges, adopt the technologies, and come out with the solutions whatever required in the society. As far as institutions are concerned, so they are supposed to at least without any notification, without any advisory, they have come forward. Most of the institution, they are. Without any appeal and all that, they are preparing sanitizers. They are educating how to hand wash, how to use the sanitizer. And at the same time, they are going to masses and they are educating for these particular precautions you have to take during this pandemic time. What I personally believe, there is a lot of information available in the social media and internet and through other medias also. But most of the time, they are in English and Hindi only. But if you want to really educate the masses, and want to bring this message to the society and real, we can say, common man of the country, you have to evolve the mechanism so that you can teach them in their own language. It means whatever standard protocols given by different bodies, you have to translate into local languages. You have to prepare the folders. You have to prepare these pamphlets. At the same time, you have to educate through phone lines and through other media, but it should be in a media and in a language which is easily understandable for the masses. Because those who are educated, they are overburdened with the informations, and those who are not educated properly, well versed with the foreign languages or Hindi languages, so they are again under fear for this crisis. This morning, I have seen a very important news from US. US FDA has given a experimental approval for this pandemic 2019. And for experimental purposes, they have cleared this this antiviral remdesivir approval, and they have given two regimes also, 5 days and 10 days. This, though this is strictly for the trial, for the experimental purposes in the case of emergency, it is not at all approved under FDA, not yet approved as a drug. But we are just looking forward to have very soon the remedies and vaccines also, because when we are talking about vaccines and new drugs, we have to take care of the safety precautions, safety measures of all the drugs and vaccines. So scientists are working day and night to achieve the we can say a target to safeguard the masses. What I am urging upon all of you, because this is one of the observations, ki whenever you are reading any news from US and UK, so they mentioned this is the problem, we have referred to this university, this is the problem, we have to refer to that university, and universities are responding and they are coming out with solution. So we are a young nation. At the same time, pharmacy profession is very young, but this should be the target in this country. We should have to identify a few unique concepts for each and every institution we are going to master in this particular unique area, and we can claim we are master and we are capable of providing information to the nation and to the profession. What I am requesting as president, what is expected from academic institutions, they should have a collaboration. We have to we can say communication with the healthcare professionals, and if there is any gap in the skill set, so this is responsibility of the teaching fraternity, they educate themselves and they start teaching coaching and training online to the workforce working in hospitals and other places through online mode. So there is no written constitution as far as this during the emergency conditions concerned. You have to identify, you have to understand your role, you have to understand your competence, you have to identify the we can say a gap in the society, and accordingly we can work for the betterment of the masses. One more observation I have, because when we are talking about the teaching and learning processes, so we have to think about different mechanisms, because what I am recommending during this pandemic, when you are sitting at home, you just visit the websites and see the concept of Bloom's taxonomy, modified Bloom's taxonomy, because nowadays we are living in a different entirely different world. Whatever you are doing, you have to prove with the numerical data that you have done something. So for this, the teaching method is totally transformed. So we have to adopt this transform mode of teaching. At the same time, we have to think about the personalized adaptive learning. Most of the accredited institutions are talking about classification of students into learners, slow learner, and fast learners. And accordingly, you have to give the assignment and plan the course material for these type of students, so that they can take the maximum advantage of those things. So personalized adopting learning, you have to think about. At the same time, the country as a whole is thinking about assessment reimagined concept. How we can go for assessment, whether it is with the help of integration of artificial intelligence and all that. At the same time, intelligent digital and physical, we can say, intervention is required. How we can club both the things together? Because with the help of this ICT, we cannot 100% replace the class board teaching, because this is a time-tested and age-old methodology. But few components we have to 100% convert into online learning and all that. We have to learn from the concept of chatbot and other leads. Then there are some concept of blended learning. And when we are talking about Industry 4.0, so we have to transform ourselves into Academia 4.0. And when we are talking about an Academia 4.0, so you have to become at least one step ahead, academic leaders, teachers 5.0, one step ahead, because the teachers are supposed to always step ahead from the society, from the profession, and they are always delivering also. Ours is the in the recent day, days become the highest, we can say, technology-driven industry. And this particular era, what is expected from you to understand and resonate from with the industry, understand their expectation, and according to their expectation, you have to remodulate your frequencies, and you have to ensure that you are still relevant and will remain relevant for the years to come. As far as the country is concerned, though, we are the example to the world that we have true leadership, and we are responding to the calls from different corners. And before this pandemic also, Government of India has identified few gray areas, and one of that gray area is APIs. And Government of India is going to give subsidies and support and everything to make this country self-sufficient as far as API is concerned. At the same time, government and technology, we have to do a lot of work, and the most important long-term vision, because our country is number seventh as far as spending in R&D area is concerned. And there is we are number six, seven, and very soon we will be number six. Because, one more observation, ki R&D contribution from the private sector is very, very minimal. So we are looking forward to have a good, much more investment in the R&D, and days are not far ahead, then we can announce that we are now having our own indigenous drug in the market. Because whatever drugs are coming in the world market, they are not coming from our land, but for the happiness and information for all of us, most of the drugs are coming where the scientists of those team are from this island only, so this nation only. So when they are bringing Lawrence while working in other countries, why they cannot do it in India? So government and other institutions are working, and we can say very soon we will have an ecosystem to have the new innovation and inventions. And again, when the mandate was given to the pharmacists to make ourselves self-sustainable and self-dependent for the production of formulations, so we have shown to the world that this we have achieved in 70 years. Now we have accepted the new challenge of new innovation inventions, and I am sure in days to come, not years, in days to come, we will have our own drug molecules that to indigenous to the service of the nation and world. So this is, all about my introductory remark, though I have taken much extra time, so I excuse for that. Still, if there is any provision of questions, so right now I can take your questions, and if not required, I can respond later on also.
Sir, thank you so much, sir. It was really a tremendous speech. I think every aspects, whatever you have shared to everyone, you can see the screen. People are so informative. Now they are collecting the exact information that really required for that time. Sir, I'll say one thing. When I put my one video, and I just remark one thing, that some people, they are working in industry. They are going every day. They are taking the risk of their life, and they are going to their industry to work, to produce some molecules, to send them all over the world. So you can't believe this. They people were so happy. And they called me back and said to me that that is the first time that somebody has put it their part, that we are working and we are part of that country and we are playing something, some role for the country. And really, sir, your words was also like that, that now the people are really recognizing pharmacists, pharma professionals.
Now you can also understand my observation. Repeatedly, sir, I have mentioned in the past, respect is always commanded, not demanded.
Demanded,
this
yes,
is the time when somebody has paid the cost and somebody has raised the bars. कई लोगों ने बहुत इसकी कीमत चुकाई है और कई लोगों ने नए स्टैंडर्ड्स ऊपर करके बार को ऊपर किया है. खत्म हो गया था भाई, बंद हो गया.
कंप्लीट हो गया.
निकल आइए
पब्लिक में नहीं एक्चुअली।